Welcome to Homeopathic Pharmacy Academia. In this session, we are going to discuss on collection of homeopathic drugs from various sources. The collection of drugs includes what are the prerequisites for collection of drugs, what are the guidelines to be followed in collection of drug substances, and what are the methods and types of collection. So these are the topics we are going to discuss today. So first we will see what are the three steps involved in the collection of drug substance. The three steps are identification of drug substances. The identification should be done by a qualified and experienced person. The experienced person is the one who possesses the basic knowledge of homeopathy. So these are the two expert people required for proper identification of drug substance. A qualified and experienced person in the respective field. So he can be a botanist, a taxonomist, a zoologist, or a chemist who can identify the proper drug substance from various sources of drugs. Then there should be one person who is having basic knowledge of homeopathy. So who are the experts required in collecting crude substances? So that depends on the nature of drug. The nature of drug, if it is a vegetable source, then a properly qualified botanist or a taxonomist should be there to identify the correct species of a plant drug. If it is an animal source, a drug from the animal source, then a zoologist or a veterinary doctor. If it is from a mineral or chemical source, then a chemist should be present, or a mineralogist should be present, or a metallurgist should be present for a proper identification. Now, coming to the NoSort. NoSort, as you know, NoSort is a drug which is prepared from deceased product or deceased secretions. So a pathologist or a microbiologist is required for proper identification of the correct NoSort. Next is Sarcode. Sarcode, a zoologist, a physiologist, or a veterinary doctor should be present at the time of collection and identification. Now, Improbilia. Improbilia, as you know, it is a drug which is prepared from energy sources that can be from a natural or a synthetic. So, a physicist should be present for a proper identification of Improbilia. Now we come to the vegetable kingdom. So there are some general rules for collection as well as a particular rule for each part of the plant. Okay. So first we'll see the general rule for collection of plant drug. So what are the general rule for plant collection? Gather plants, not destroy them. So whenever you want to collect any plant drug substance, you just pick the plant part, or you just gather the parts which is required only. Don't destroy them. never mix different species. You may have several subspecies and several species of drug substance, but what you want to do is you identify a particular species and collect them and do not mix with different species of the plant. So that will interfere with the quality of the drug substance. So each species should be separately collected. Gather only healthy and clean plant. If suppose the plant is damaged or it is spoiled, do not collect them. Only collect the healthy plant which is having a vitality and vigor. Gather indigenous plant. Indigenous means the plant which grow in our own locality or the natural habitat of the plant. And it is better to avoid the cultivated plants because the cultivated plants may not contain proper active principles which are responsible for the pharmacological action. So you collect the indigenous plant which is grown on its own natural habitat. Discard old and unhealthy plants. So when you collect a unhealthy plant, that does not that will spoil very easily, that will decay easily, so that is not apt for or suit for preparing medicinal substances. And many times some of the plants are not indigenous to our country, so it may have to export from the other countries, exogenic plants. So in exporting from or importing from the other countries, you are more vigilant towards the quality of the drug substance. So extra quality inspection is required when the plant is collected from other countries or other places or other than indigenous plants. And next one is avoid plants growing in polluted areas. So environment polluted areas like water pollution or air pollution, the plants growing in such areas also may be polluted. So it contains sometimes some chemicals or some noxious substances which can hinder the action of such medicinal plants. So better to avoid the plants which is growing in polluted areas. And sometimes in the soil itself, there may be soil contaminations will be there with chemicals or some extra minerals. So that such plants can be avoided. Gather plants early morning of sunny day. That is a usual time of collection of the plant. So that in that morning, the plant will be more vigor and more, it is having more vitality. Cleanse plant after the collections. So you need to collect, we need to clean the plants after the collection, but the cleaning should not be vigorous. It will be mildly clean. Otherwise, the vitality of the plant will be lost. Do not rely only on wild sources. So I told you that we need to collect plants from indigenous origin, but sometimes the cultivated plants also can be used in case if you are doubt in the wild species. So if you are not sure about the correct species when it is growing in the habitat of that particular plant, so you can collect even from the correct species which is cultivated one. Parts to be gathered, medicinally useful parts containing maximum concentration of active principles. So these active principles like alkaloids, glycosides, saponins, tannins, etc., they are pharmacologically active substances or chemicals, which is known as phytochemicals. And this is the pharmacologically or medicinally active substances. So it should be the parts which contain maximum amount of active principles or phytochemicals should be collected, and that will be specified in the monograph of under that particular plant in the pharmacopoeia. Now there are some factors influencing the concentration of active components. Let us see what are the the factors influencing the concentration of active components. The first one is the age of the plant. Okay, it should not be neither young nor it should be old. It should have a sufficient age to have maximum concentration of active principles or maximum concentration of medicinally active chemicals in it. So big or small, whatever it may be, it should be in an appropriate age. Climate and soil. So climate and soil is very, very important. The climate and soil where the plant is growing. So if the climate is usually the sunny and the plants collected during rainy season may not have much active principle in that because it may be diluted. So a proper climate should be you should aware about, and that will be specified in each monograph. And soil rich in some minerals may not be suited for some medicinal plants. So it should be appropriately manured, and the balance of the micronutrients in the soil should be balanced. Now cultivation. So cultivation also is a factor influencing the concentration of active principles. So if it is cultivated properly, then it may have maximum concentration of active principles. And that is common with that is why we are lay mainly on natural plants, because in a natural habitat the plant is it is having a balanced nutrients in its natural environment. So that is why we prefer on natural habitat of the plant. If it is cultivated, it may be the micronutrients may be excess or it may be lacking, which in turn affect the concentration of active components. Now particular rules for plant collection. What are the particular rules? Particular rules means for collecting each part of the plant, there should be a separate season or climate or method. The first one is gather at a specific time of the year. Sometimes some parts of the plant should be collected in a specified time of the year. Whole plant in flowering season. So if you are collecting the whole plant, including root, it is a better time is the flowering season. Suppose if you collect only flowers from a plant, it should be collected partially in bud and partially in blossom. So it will be half blossomed flowers. So that will have a more vitality in it. Now, suppose if you are collecting only leaves from the plant, then it should be early blooming season before the flowers are grown. So the better time is just before the flowering season, where the plant is having more vitality and maximum concentration of active principles. Stems, when to collect stems? After the leaves appears, but before the flowers grow. So that is a most appropriate time for collection of stem, where the stem is having more vitality and vigor, and it contains more amount of phytochemicals. Flower clusters, before they reach the flowering stage. So flower clusters means it may have the flower bud, inflorescence, then tender leaves, etc. So before they reach the flowering stage, it should be collected. Now bark of resinous trees collected early in the spring. Resinous trees are the trees which can produce resins. You know, some fluid, if you injure the tree, there will be some sticky or non-sticky fluid from the tree. There will be oozing of some liquids. So that is called as resinous trees. So it should be collected early spring before blooming season. And when the bark of the non-resinous tree is collected, it should be late in the autumn. So these are the seasonal preferences for collecting a bark of tree for resinous trees and non-resinous trees. Now roots and rhizomes. So roots and rhizome, as you know, it will be in underground. Rhizome is a modified stem. It should be collected when all leaves have fallen. You have several examples for that, like onion. When to collect onion, the leaves began to decay. That is a time where we can see, because it is in underground, we cannot see whether the roots and rhizomes are matured. So how we can assume that when all the leaves are decayed or fallen, then we assume that the roots or rhizomes are mature enough to collect. Similarly, in the case of some rhizomes, ginger. So the ginger also, how you collect it, when you collect the rhizome of the ginger, when the leaves began to decay, we assume that the rhizomes of the ginger will be mature enough to collect. Now end shoot should be collected in the spring. Fix at current year's growth. Fruits and berries and its seeds, it should be collected when fully in ripe. So usually fruits should be collected when it should be ripe enough to collect. Bulbs, like roots and rhizomes, mature when the leaves began to decay. Now woods, that is a thick part of the tree, in early spring or late autumn, before the juices are not exhausted and mature, young trees or trees like shrubs. So it should be mature enough to collect the woods. So if the wood, it is not matured, then it is not appropriate for using medicinal usage. Resins, gum, lattices, etc., as soon as they ooze out of the plant. Herbs, when it is fully developed. Narcotic plants means the plants which is showing the property of narcotics. So for example, opium or cannabis, all these are narcotic plants. When in bloom or just before or when coming to bloom, so that is the time when we need to collect the narcotic plants. Now this is about the vegetable sources. Now we'll coming to animal sources. So what are the prerequisites of animal collecting the animal sources? General rule for collection of animal drugs: select animals properly, select the healthy animals, discard unhealthy animals, do not kill the animal. Suppose if you want to collect the physiological secretion, collect it without killing the animal. But if you want to take a healthy organ out of the animal, then we need to sacrifice it without causing any pain to animal. There are methods for sacrificing the animals without causing much pain to animals. Test animal matters or part. So whatever is using, whether it is sacrificing or not, we should test the health of the animal before the parts or the organs or the secretions are taken from the particular animals. Collect animal substance in genuine. So genuine substance should be collected. Do not rely only on wild sources. So we can collect it from a nurtured one or a cultivated one also. Particular rules for collection of animal drug substances are fishes gathered by fishing. So we are using different types of fishes for making medicines, like codfish, then eel fish serum is taking, eel serum. So the fish are gathered by the method of fishing. Now wild animals are collected by hunting. Next is snake venom. Snake venoms require a training for collecting the venoms from the snakes. So the experts should be present by collecting the venoms of the snakes. And the collection of venoms, there are many methods for collection of venoms, and it should be done in a serological lab, in a well controlled laboratory. Elaps coralinus, that is one coral snake. The venom is collected by pressing a butter plate against the fangs or letting the snake bite through the cloth covering a white bottle. So this is how most of the time the venom is collected. Now viper or crotalus, the venom is collected by pressing the gland. So by pressing the gland by the expert, the venom will be secreted out. Now lactasis or surukuku snake, the venom is obtained from a living snake by stunning it with a blow, and once it is unconscious, then collecting the poison on sugar of milk by pressing the fangs upwards against the poison sac. So pressing the fangs against upward, either using a forceps or just pressing it at the walls of the glass bottle. The next one is Naja. The venom is obtained by a special device by compressing the gland of the serpent. Now another poisonous animal is a toad, poison toad. So here the poison is collected from the back of the poison is present in the back of the toad, the dorsal glands of the toad, and the live toad is fastened to a slab. Then the pulse of the injection apparatus in action are slowly drawn over the back of the animal, whereupon poison exudates from the dorsal glands of toad, which is removed and with a small horn made knife. So here it should be properly fastened. Then the injection apparatus are slowly drawn over the back. Then you can see the poisonous glands present in the back of the toad, and it is a very highly poisonous animal. The toad with a horn made knife, the poison is taken. So this is how the poison is taken from the toad. Next is Spanish fly. So the Spanish fly, these are the flies, insects which are swam on the trees, collected in the morning on sunrise. So it will be swam around the trees in the morning time. So that can be collected in the May or June. Next is the mineral kingdom. So mineral kingdom, it should be collected from the reliable sources. As far as possible, it should be certified. Take utmost care while collecting the drug substance of mineral kingdom or mineral source, and do not mix them. Take precautionary measures while dealing with chemicals and minerals. Do not collect in the form of fine powder, because in fine powder it is very difficult to identify, because most of the chemicals are white in color, and it is very difficult to differentiate, and we need to have a separate assays for identification of these chemicals. Now no salts, as you know, it is a medicine prepared from a diseased parts or diseased secretions or diseased excretions. So there are some general methods for collection and preparation of the strain. So here, the as I said before, there are four types of method, four different types, that is N1, N2, N3 and N4. Type of nozots, and that depends on from where the nozots are prepared from. So here the microbes available as pure organism are obtained from suitable clinical material from substances suffering from diseases are isolated, cultured, and identified. Their properties are studied for complete identification as per individual monograph, and they are lyophilized to ensure the preservation and stability of the characteristics. So here the microbes or the pure organisms, microbial organisms are collected from a particular clinical material, whether it is a sputum or a pus or any type of secretions from a diseased individual, diseased subject. It should be isolated and it should be cultured. That particular microorganism should be cultured and it should be properly identified. Then once it is identified, or once the properties of this particular microorganism is studied, then we can go for the preparations, and it should be preserved properly, and the stability of the microorganism should be ensured. So what are the steps involving in collection of nozotes? The first one is the preparation of culture medium. As I said, the microorganism isolated from the particular clinical material should be cultured in properly. So for culturing microorganism, a culture media is required. Freshly isolated organism invariably of S types are recommended. Stock of nozote should be made from recently isolated organism. Stock means the extract, the crude extract of the nozotes. So that should be made from a recently isolated organism, not from an old one. Culture should be kept below 5 degrees Celsius. So that is an apt temperature. Stock culture most often maintained in a lyophilized state. Preserved properly, the culture allowed to incubate for 24 hours at 37 degrees Celsius. So it should be intubated at 24 hours at 37 degrees Celsius. Then at the end of incubation, the microorganisms are harvested under aseptic conditions by pouring sterile isotonic salt solution on the solid media and generally shaking on scraping until all the microorganisms are suspended. So once the microorganisms are cultured enough, then it should be harvested. It should be separated out by pouring a sterile isotonic salt solution over the solid media, then shaking it on scraping until all the microorganisms are suspended in that particular isotonic salt solution. The suspension is centrifuged at 30 minutes. Once it is centrifuged, the suspension is discarded. The liquid which comes in the upper layer should be discarded. The bacterial pellets, so that is for separating the liquid part and the solid bacterial part, we are centrifuging for 30 minutes. And once the solid bacterial pellets are suspended in 0.9% sodium chloride solution, then it should be shaken well and again it should be centrifuged. So that is to the objective of centrifugation is to separate the solid bacterial pellet from the liquid portion. The suspension of bacteria examined for purity. In case of contamination, the lot should be rejected. Suppose if any other bacteria are cultured or any type of other contamination occurs, then the particular lot, particular batch should be rejected and a fresh strain should be used. So after 24 hours of growth in incubation, a colony is re-examined for checking the characteristic and the purity of the strain. So each bacterial strain have its own characteristics. Suppose some bacteria, when it grows, it becomes a white color. Sometimes the bacteria grows, when it grows, it becomes a yellow color. Sometimes there will be a green color growth. So that depends on the characteristic of each bacterial strain. So we can, when you incubate it for the growth 24 hours, after 24 hours, we can visually see the characteristic and the purity of the strain. The culture is then taken up in 0.9% aqueous sodium chloride solution. The growth is suspended again in isotonic solution, shaken to break up clumps and to make uniform suspension. So again, it should be suspended in a isotonic solutions and to shaken to break up any clumps in the solutions and make it uniform suspension. And in this suspension, the number of bacteria in each milliliter, it should be of minimum 20 billion viable cell per milliliter. So that is the quality of the bacterial suspension. So each 1 milliliter of the suspension, there should be 20 billion viable cells. So that should be the minimum number. And it forms the original stock in case of drug of N1 and N2 type of nozotes. And for N3 and N4, the strength of 1x should be 1 part of pure materials in 10 parts of suspending or diluting materials. So which may be a lactose or glycerin as suggested in the monographs of pharmacopoeia. Now coming to sarcodes. Sarcodes, as you know, it is from a healthy organs or healthy secretions or healthy endocrine or exocrine glands or its secretions. Should collect from apparently healthy animals. Keep animals under observation before collecting the sarcode. Collect from the reliable sources. So we should be having enough knowledge about the correct species of before collecting the sarcode. Endocrine secretions and few enzymes may be collected from cattle, sheep, etc. from the slaughterhouses. Now next one is imponderabilia. Imponderabilia, as you know, it is from energy sources. It can be natural sources or synthetic sources. The rules of collecting imponderabilia is given in respective monograph in the pharmacopoeia. The magnet can be collected from the physical laboratory and we should check for the strength of the magnet. In case of Luna, we are preparing medicine from the moonlight also. So the full moon is suggested. For X-ray, contact chemical testing laboratory, the X-ray should having a particular strength of X-ray should be used as per the monographs of pharmacopoeia. So these are some special precaution considered while preparing or collecting medicines under the imponderabilia sources. So this is about the collection of